It was a busy day for the Prime Minister. He started at a job centre in the heart of London, reinforcing his government's long-term commitment to employment. He and Work and Pensions Secretary Peter Hain took time out to speak to welfare officials and young people. The two men will later publish a document taking stock of the achievements of Labour's New Deal over the past 10 years, and, perhaps more importantly, addressing how it now needs to be adapted for the future. The New Deal initiative, offering a mix of training and advice on employment, was, at one stage, helping someone in the UK find work every 3 minutes.
Yeah, absolutely, as far as I'm aware, they're still with us. So, yeah, that's right. We just opened 2 flagship stores in London, and that's what we were recruiting for, really. And at Christmas time, that's quite difficult. We've had great success.
She's quite flexible, she's lovely, actually.
So what do you do, 16, 17 hours a week? Or
20 hours a week.
Oh, 20 hours a week. Yeah.
And you're better off on that?
Yes, yeah. And I'm happy.
Later at Downing Street, Britain's Prime Minister took time out to explain the continuing diplomatic moves to try and stop the bloodshed in Kenya.
The whole international community has been coming together to try and bring an end to violence in Kenya. And I believe there is a responsibility on the part of all opposition and government leaders in Kenya to call on their supporters to end the violence that's taking place. I've just talked to President Kafur of Ghana. He's the chairman of the African Union, well-respected right across Africa, someone who has promoted democratic rights in his country and throughout Africa. And I welcome his decision that he will announce later today that he will go to Kenya. He will meet President Kibaki and Mr. Odinga tomorrow. He will call on them to urge their supporters to end violence, and he will work with the parties to ensure that reconciliation is brought about. And perhaps a chance that some of the people who are at the moment opponents may join a government of national unity. I think it's very important that the international community supports the efforts of President Kafur. He is trying very hard with other people to bring an end to the violence, and we will give whatever support we can to President Kafur's mediation, which will take place tomorrow. I think you'll know that Britain's been involved throughout in this. I've been talking to President Kibaki and to Mr. Odinga myself. I've been talking to President Kafur of Ghana. I've been talking to Mr. Kaba, who's the Commonwealth person on the ground, the former president of Sierra Leone. And we've had very intense diplomatic activity because it's very important. Millions of people queued up in Kenya to cast their vote. They deserve a government that brings about stability and prosperity. They deserve to have a government that reflects the will of the people. Any election irregularities have got to be properly investigated. And I think it's very important now that we do our bit and we do what we can to bring about reconciliation and unity in the country, and particularly at this moment when we've seen such appalling and horrific and completely unjustifiable killings, to bring the violence to an end as quickly as possible.
Gordon Brown says Britain will continue to offer all diplomatic support to promoting a peaceful settlement to the situation.